Welcome back everybody to another Pathfinder Wrath of the Righteous video. Today we're going to talk about the top 3 items that you can pick up in the early game, which is going to help you a lot, especially if you're playing on the higher difficulties, because my guides, as per usual, are geared towards people who are playing on the higher difficulties. But if you're playing on the lower difficulties, they're still going to be amazing, but the thing is there are many, many more items which are viable, of course, for the lower difficulties. Items which force your opponent to take a reflex save, a fortitude save, or a will save will be very good on the lower difficulties, but of course if you play on a higher difficulty they will always pass those saves, so they're gonna be almost useless. But there are a couple of items which of course don't use those saves and which are simply amazing for unfair difficulties. So the first item, which is one of the best items you can pick up in the early game, which I define as like before you get to Dresden essentially, this item you will be able to pick up when you get to the Crusader's camp. This is going to be after you have the encounter with Minago at the Wardstone place. When you get your first mythic level, you get to the Crusader's camp, you can talk to Wills and Garms, show me what you have, and if you have enough money, because it's not a cheap item, it's a very, very expensive item, you can pick up the Wide Sweep, of course. Wide Sweep is a scythe, and if you watch my video, by the way, there's going to be a link down below, down to my entire playthrough on upper difficulty. You will know about my love for scythes, because of course scythes have the highest critical modifier. So with that, it's a x4 on the modifier. It also has an enhancement of +2, which means you get +2 on your attack roll and on your damage, which is very, very good. But that's not why this is amazing. There are other items which have +2. There are other items which have high critical modifier and all that. But this item in particular has the very good ability here that it deals weapon damage to all adjacent enemies. But as it so happens, I don't know if this is a bug or a feature or whatever, but it doesn't only deal the weapon damage. It doesn't just deal 2d4 +2 damage to every adjacent enemy. It deals the full amount of damage, which means you get your strength modifier. If you get a charge with spirited charge, you get that modifier. You get everything on everybody. And not only that. If only that, it would still be the best item, or one of the best items in the game. But not only that, it also works with Cleaving Finish and double dips with Cleaving Finish. So let's just jump into a little bit of a clip here, and I think you will understand why this item is so insanely good. Here's my recording. I'm gonna make myself a little bit smaller, just so that you can see. And we're just gonna play this straight away. So we might just do this. Charge in. Get a couple of ghouls. Okay, that was a couple of ghouls. And now we're just ready to... Oh man, are you going? Oh my god, she killed almost everybody there. Yes, so what happened there, you can see here in the combat log that we triggered Wide Sweep, which... And we also triggered Cleaving Finish because we hit something and we killed it, which means that both abilities happened at the same time. And then the Cleaving Finish triggered another Wide Sweep. So we got another round of killing. So we killed essentially everything with one attack. As you can see, the first initial attack dealt 81 damage, then we did 53, 51, 57, 59, 53. So everything just got splattered by that one weapon. That is why that is one of the best early game items you can get. To be able to find the next item, you need to unlock the Lich Mythic Pass. So if you don't know how to do that, I'm going to show you how to do it very, very quickly. First of all, when you have defeated the Veska War Queen in the Leper's Smile, you need to go down here. Next, you need to follow this path right here. So you need to walk past this boulder and just follow this path. This is still in Leper's Smile, but it's in the underground. You need to walk through this path right here. So next, we're gonna pick up the Lich's Wand. It's going to be at the very, very end of this cave, and it's gonna look something like this, green and glowing. And as long as that wand is there, as long as you haven't picked it up or broken it, don't break it, by the way, you need to pick it up for this to work, the ghouls are going to respawn again and again and again. So there's no use in trying to kill them, because you're just gonna come back. But if you do this, for instance, you go invisible, like I do in this clip right here, you sneak in, you pick up the wand, invisible, that's preferred way of doing it there, I would say. Especially on unfair difficulty, because that's kind of difficult. And then you hide it in your bag. Not hide it in your bag. That's all you need to do for now. Next, you're going to have to wait until you get to the Lost Chapel part of the game. You're going to be on this map here, called the Lost Chapel. And in this room right here, you will find Galfrey, and she's going to help you to kill these ghouls. You don't need to kill these ghouls, by the way. You can just let her kill all of them. Pro tip. Anyways, if you have the Lich Wand with you, this wall here is going to disappear and you're going to be able to go downstairs. Now that we're down here in the Lost Chapel, what we're gonna do, we're gonna make our way through the hallway here, and we're gonna find Lich here, we're gonna return his wand. Then there's going to be a perception check here to be able to find this secret wall, which we're gonna open. We go through, and then there's going to be three traps that we need to disarm. Then in this room, there's going to be a specter and a golem patrolling here, which you need to take care of. And then when you've taken care of them, there's going to be a book laying right here. Just to give you a little bit of perspective, this is where you come in. You need to make your way through here, and right here, you're gonna find the duality of conjuration and summoning. So this item is rather complicated, but let's read through this together. This book allows you to summon a demon or angel once per day. If the owner is evil aligned, it will summon 1d2 plus 1 monadic divas, so it summons the opposite of what you are here. If the owner is good aligned, it will summon 1d2 plus 1 Nabasa demons. If the wearer is neutral, there's an equal chance to summon an angel or demons. Duration of summoning is equal to the owner's level. There's a 10% chance that the creature will break free from the control and start attacking the owners. This is per summon. So every summon has a 10% chance. It's not that everybody is gonna go against you. If you summon three of them, everybody has a 10% chance. Each of these individual has a 10% chance to attack you. So, next part. This book has 10 pages, and each time the owner uses it to summon a creature, they receive one of the following scrolls randomly. So then there's a couple of bonus scrolls which just last for 1 hour. We don't need to go through all of them. But then there's two things here at the bottom. Scroll of Resourceful Smite. You gain an additional smite per day permanently. Okay. This kind of effect can only be applied once per creature. And Resourceful Rage. You get an additional rage per day permanently. So all your paladins and all your barbarians are gonna need this item. But that is not all. If that was it, it would still be super duper good. But the devas that you summon, I think we need to show you with a clip here. Because I think it's best shown with a clip how good these devas are. This is unpredictable, as are all my clips, by the way. God, these devas are good. What have we picked up? That item is insane. And we are fighting Incubus, by the way. This is real me. This is recording me. What are these devas? Exactly. What are these devas? Not only that, but this item is currently bugged also. Use it if you want to, that bug. So when you have this item on, if you save... If you have zero shards on this for the day, you can save and reload and you will get all your shards back. But use it only if you want to really cheese something. Last item on the list is kind of obvious, but it would be weird if it wasn't on the list, right? So of course it's gonna be Finian the Talking Weapon. If you don't know how to get Finian the Talking Weapon, I'm gonna show you how to get him. So, when you picked up Wolf Jidge, which you can pick up, by the way, in the Defender's Heart basement if you haven't picked him up already. So when you have picked him up and you're starting doing his quest, you're gonna go to a place called Ancient Trees and Wanderer's Shop after you talk to Irabeth about his quest. Then you will find Finian the Talking Weapon. He's going to be here. You cannot miss him. And when you've picked him up, it's gonna look like this. If you go to, the character page, the inventory I mean, you are going to have a button here called Finian. When you press Finian and you press one of your companion, you press the drop-down list, you're going to be able to select a weapon. And this, of course, I'm going to choose a scythe. And it's going to turn into a plus one weapon. But it also has the very, very useful ability Ghost Touch. Ghost Touch means that when you're fighting ghosts, when you're fighting specters and such like that, which are kind of annoying to deal with and hard to deal with, because they only take half the damage, they actually take full damage from Finian the Talking Weapon. And it's amazing. That's why it's number 3.